Hello and welcome to Nikolai's Genetics Lessons, and today's problem is in Cocker Spaniels the following genotypes and phenotypes are found. And here is a list of genotypes and phenotypes, so genotypes on the left and phenotypes on the right. And we have three questions. A red female is mate with a liver-colored male, and one of the pups produced is lemon-colored. What are the genotypes of the parents? So, let's analyze step by step a red female. So, red is here, and this is genotype. So, let's put it here. So, first allele is known. Second allele is not known. And then, two small b's. And we have to cross with another genotype or phenotype, which is a liver-colored male. This is phenotype, so it is here. Once again, one of the alleles are not known. So, genotype is small a, and capital B, and blank space. And one of the pups produced is lemon-colored. So, where is the lemon? And lemon genotype is here. So, result of this cross was one pup that had a genotype that is small a, and small b. So, what is the genotypes of the parents? As you see, in order for one of the pups to be lemon in color, this pup have to get two recessive alleles. He can get one recessive allele, as you see, allele A from his father's side, and another recessive allele this pup have to get from his mother's side. So, we now know that mother is heterozygous for the gene A. And the same situation for the gene B. The pup have two recessive alleles. We know that one of recessive alleles he can get from his mother's side, another recessive allele he have to get from his father's side. So now we know genotype of these two colors. So red color is heterozygous for the gene A, and liver is heterozygous for gene B. So now we know genotypes of red and liver color. Now we can move to the question B. What proportion of this offspring would be expected to be black? We don't know what is the second allele have to be, but I will show you that this is not important for our calculation. So according to this genotype, we have to find what is the proportion of such a cross would be heterozygous for gene A. So our first parent is heterozygous for this gene, our second parent is homozygous recessive. So first parent is heterozygous, second is homozygous recessive. So let's find how many of the progeny would be also heterozygous for this gene A. As you see, black have to have heterozygous state of the gene A. So capital A small a here, small a here, capital A here, and small a here. And according to our Punnett square, as you see, one half of the progeny, genotype would be capital A and small a. But this is not the end of the story. We also have to find how many of the progeny would have capital B, dominant allele B, for the gene B. So, once again, the first parent is homozygous recessive. The second, we know, is heterozygous. So, capital B and small b, and small b for second parent. And Once again, capital B, small b here, small b here, capital B, small b here, and small b here. Once again, as you see, we have 50% chances that for the gene B, progeny would have one dominant allele, like in this black genotype. So capital B, small b, so 1/2 probability here, 1/2 probability here, and we have to multiply these two probabilities, and the answer would be 1/4. So 1/4 of such a cross would produce progeny that is going to be heterozygous for the gene A and would be heterozygous for the gene B. So probability of such an event 1/4 or 25%. But we cannot fill, we cannot put any letters here because it can be capital B here or small b, and still this would produce black phenotype. And question C, a black male is mate with a liver colored female, and they produce the following pups: 3/8 black, 1/8 red, 3/8 liver colored, and 1/8 lemon colored. What are the genotypes of two parents? We know the genotype of the liver colored parent, but we don't know for sure what is the genotype of the black colored parent. So let me move a little bit in order to clean a space. So basically we have a choice whether a black parent may have dominant allele here or recessive allele. So but first let's draw a Punnett square for the allele A. We know that black parent is heterozygous and liver colored parent is homozygous recessive. So capital A, small a goes from here, flock from black colored parent, and small a goes here on the side from the second parent. So now when we build a Punnett square, we can predict all the genotypes that is possible and their frequency. So capital A, small a here, small a here, capital A, small a here, and small a here. Now as for the gene B, the first parent can be homozygous dominant or heterozygous. So let's add couple more Punnett squares. So our first assumption would be that first parent would be homozygous dominant, another that he is going to be heterozygous, and the second parent, we know genotype that is heterozygous, so capital B, small b, capital B, and small b. So once again, let's build a Punnett square, and when we check all the frequencies of the progeny, we would find exact genotype of the first parent, which is now is not known, whether it is this parent is heterozygous for gene B or whether he is homozygous. So we would have capital B here, capital B here, capital B here, and capital B here. Capital B here, capital B here, capital B small b here, and small b here. So once again, here we assume that black parent is homozygous dominant for the gene B, and here we assume that he is heterozygous for gene B. And this Punnett square, we know for sure genotypes of both parents. So in order for the progeny to be black, we see that 3/8 are black, and black genotype is have to be heterozygous for gene A. So probability of such genotype would be 1/2 for the gene A, and probability that at least one allele would be dominant would be 100%. As you see, here we have two dominant alleles, here we have two dominant alleles, here we have at least one dominant allele, and here we have at least one dominant allele. So basically, if we would multiply probability for the gene A to be heterozygous, which is 1/2, by 4 over 4, which is 1. So probability that if black parent would be homozygous dominant for this trait, that probability that they would have also black pups would be 1/2. So basically 1/2 multiplied by 1, any number multiplied by 1 would be the same number. So probability would be 1/2. But we see that our expectation have to be 3/8. So let's check now second assumption, that black has have to be heterozygous for the gene B. In this case, as you see, 3/4 of the progeny would have at least one dominant allele. So let's do our calculations one more time. For the gene A, we have the same calculation, that half of the progeny would be heterozygous, so 1/2. And that second gene B would be whether homozygous dominant or heterozygous. Probability, as you see, is 3/4. So if we multiply these numbers, we are going to get 3/8. So our assumption that black parent is heterozygous for the gene B is confirmed by numbers that we got here. 3/8 progeny we expect to be black. And just let's check the second one. We expect that 1/8 of the progeny would be red. But what is the genotype of the red? And as you see, it have to be heterozygous for the gene A and homozygous recessive for the gene B. So let's now return to our Punnett squares. When we assume that black parent is homozygous dominant for the gene B, we don't see any homozygous recessiveness for the gene B here at all. But here we see that 1/4 of the progeny would be homozygous recessive for the gene B. So once again, in order for the pup to be red, he have to be heterozygous for the gene A, and probability is 1/2. So 1/2 we have to multiply by the probability to be homozygous recessive for the gene B, which is 1/4, and the answer would be 1/8. And this is exactly what we see here. So I'm not going to do calculations for the rest variants, because now it's clear that we can exclude this genotype, and black have to be heterozygous. This is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please write your comments, questions if you have any. And see you in the next video. Goodbye.